I've been asked to talk about myself. I spent most of my life trying not to talk about myself. In fact, I've almost achieved it recently. We all have egos, I suppose, especially musicians. I spend most of your life trying so hard to not name drop and build yourself up, hype yourself bigger than you are, because it's all survival, but you try not to do it too obviously. Now, I'm being told, talk yourself, tell everybody, because everyone's doing it now, and this is the way you have to sell yourself with the digital age, all these things, YouTube, Facebook, the rest, all those bollocks. You've got to sell yourself, and people are telling me now, oh, talk, tell them about it. All those years attempting not to seem wasted.
Yeah. All right, another one off the CD.
My first guitar, 9 guineas. I remember guitars were a dirty word in those days, rock and roll, early rock and roll days. You know, Blackboard Juggle, Bill Haley, all that. And relatives and friends of my parents suggested I shouldn't have a guitar. It wasn't right, you know, sort of thing. But my father, good old boy, said, no, he can have a guitar, but he has got to pay for it himself. He's got to sell something. So I sold my stamp album, I think, for about 10 quid. Bought a guitar for 9 guineas. Action that high. Cut my fingers trying to play. It was, but I'm not the only one who started like that, I believe. The great, one of my top people, George Benson, I believe. And people like that, when they started out, they were cutting their fingers, they were bleeding, I suppose. It was difficult. We didn't have the low action light strings you have today.
You're all still with us, so here's a Bill With Us song.
Oh,
how do you turn a duck into a soul singer?
don't know.
You put it in the microwave until it's Bill Withers.
Oh.
That's terrible.
As you're there, you might as well sing along on the long note. Nigel will show you the notes.
Oh my.
When I wake up in the morning, love, and the sunlight hurts my eyes, something with that morning, love, bears heavy on my mind. Then I look at you, ah, the world's alright with me. Just one look at you, gonna be a lovely day. Somebody sing that note with them, please, David. Is it nice to lovely day? Lovely day, lovely day, lovely day, lovely day, lovely day, lovely day, lovely day. When the day that lies ahead of me seems impossible to face, someone else instead of me always seems to know the way. Then I look at you, the world's alright with me. Oh, just one look at you, I know it's gonna be
today on guitars. So anyway, next guitar's an 18 guinea Hofner Senator acoustic. I had a little pickup extra for that for the neck. The third guitar shortly after was a 44 guinea Hofner President Electric. That was great. That had a cutaway. Everyone wanted a guitar with a cutaway. So, and then the big crunch was when I had to make a decision on my life, work-wise. My father offered to sign the hire purchase, that means installments in those days, hire purchase agreement for me to, I had to pay it myself somehow, but pocket money or whatever, odd jobs, but hire purchase agreement for either a, what I really wanted was a Fender Stratocaster, Fender Strat, and I had the option of that or a shotgun, because which was a, the guitar was 140 guineas, I think, with a hard case at Jennings up in Charing Cross Road. It was the only place you could buy a Fender in those days. You couldn't buy them anywhere else, only at Jennings Music Shop, Vox in Charing Cross Road. And the other option was a shotgun from Thomas Bland, oddly enough, was round the corner in William the Fourth Street then, I think, well, somewhere down towards Charing Cross Station. And that's just south of, just about a quarter of a mile down the road, not even that. And that was a side-by-side pure gauge shotgun, because the job I, the chance to become a trainee gamekeeper was in the office with my father through a contact. But fun.
Sitting on the corner of the moon, wishing you, that's it, would get here soon, whistling a lunar tune, waiting for the next balloon. Reflections of the past are on my face, don't know why I joined this race. Without you I feel out of place. It's so lonely here in our space, babe. I'm the loneliest man on the moon, spending my nights with the meteorites. Sharing my lips with a total eclipse, and I don't think you're coming back soon.
Oh, baby.
Something like that. Stars are falling down from the sky.
Get it wrong.
Teardrops falling from my eyes when I saw you wave goodbye. You were in. I was in a cloud, babe. I'm the loneliest man on the moon, spending my nights with the meteorites. I don't see another balloon, and I'm the loneliest man on the moon.
Father wanted me to have an outdoor job and it'd be healthier for me, you know. So rather than working in an office, as he'd always done all his life, so. I had the option of the shotgun, which was 175 guineas, 170 guineas, or the guitar, 140. Wildlife was my big love up till then. Always had been, really. Ornithology, I was so interested, you know. I used to read the Observer's books of reptiles and study them thoroughly, and birds, and knew every flipping thing about everything wildlife then. But I chose the guitar as opposed to the gun, and so I didn't become a gamekeeper, I went into the music industry eventually. So got the Fender Strat, and from that went on. I had a red Strat, it was a 1959 Strat, if I remember correctly. Was one of the first Rosewood fingerboard. That now I'm told it would be worth about 30 grand, of course, something like that, 20, 30 grand. After that I went on to Telecasters, a couple of Gibsons, Fender Tellies, I love Telly. They're the main guitars, Gibson or Fender, really, depending on what you're playing. You know. I had a Gretsch for a while, big Chet Atkins fan. Went on.
Cash, you better club it, put it right in, man.
How you doing, stranger?
Oh, yes.
You've been a long, long while. I didn't see you there till I recognized your smile. Can't believe it after all this time. How did you know I'd be here? You must have wrecked my mind.
Oh shit, that's marvelous.
Read my mind. Da 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 da. I've forgotten the second verse because I haven't done it for so many years. Da 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 da. Guess I'm just a sentimental kind. How did you know I'd be here? You must have read my mind.
Not gonna remember the bridge.
Come back with that again. Still together, I'd be satisfied today. Why did I have to break your heart? I never realized until you went away how much I needed you. Baby, I still do. Can't find a reason to stand there in the rain when we could be somewhere. Falling back in love again. A second chance at love is hard to find. Would I like to come home with you? read my mind. You really read my mind. See right through me, baby. Really read my mind. See right through me, baby.
That red Fender Strat was sold to somebody in a band because they needed a bass player. I went looking for a job, a place called the Crown Hotel in Raleigh. That was my first gig ever. I went to look for a job within the middle, on the middle of the week. I went to this venue, real rough place if I remember, in the Raleigh Crown Hotel and the ballroom out the back. Sort of place when there were trouble there all the time, fights, and the bouncers used to throw the, it was upstairs, up steep stone staircase, I remember. And as in other joints that I've worked in later, the bouncers used to throw the troublemakers over the top of the, over the wall onto the parking lot and drop them over the wall. It's quite a rough place there.
Where the man says clear today, he doesn't know you've gone away and it's raining. Raining in my heart. Oh, misery, misery. What's gonna become of me? I tell my blues they mustn't show, but still those tears they start to flow. 'Cause it's raining in my heart. Gonna become of me. I tell my blues they mustn't show, but still those tears they start to flow. 'Cause it's raining in my heart, raining in my heart, it's raining. In my heart.
But I went down here looking for a job. The band there was a group called The Planets. They didn't have a bass player, but they needed one. So they offered to buy me a precision bass if I let me play bass, providing I sold the Fender Strat, the 59 Strat, to the lead guitarist who had a homemade guitar at the time. So he took over my guitar. I had a bass, a Vox AC 30 amp, became a bass player. I wasn't pretty good. Plectrum bass player, not that there's anything wrong with that, but I wasn't one of like bass players today, you know. Victor Wooden, I wasn't one of those. I don't think anyone was then. But basically,
It's very clear. Our love is here to stay. Not for a year, but ever and a day. On the radio, the telephone, the movies that we know may just be passing fancies. Time may go, but oh my dear, our love is here to stay. Together we're going along.
to put it in stay. Boss. Put it in boss.
It's very clear.
Boss and over.
Our love is here to complicate. Not for a year, but ever and a day. The radio, the telephone, the movies that we know may just be passing pences, and in time may come. But oh my dear, our love is here to stay. Together we're going a long, long way. In time the Rockies may crumble, Gibraltar may tumble, they're only made of clay. But our love is here too. Our love is here too. Our love is here too. Group called the Espresso Five. I suppose they were the first pro band because they were local band, but they were travelling and doing the Mecca circuits. So I played at the Mecca Hall, the Locarno in Basildon, a new town then, Basildon, new town, with the Espresso Five as a bass player. Then from there we moved to Stevenage, Locarno. First stage I ever worked on, in fact the only other stage I've ever worked on, other than the Palladium, where they have a revolving stage. I always remember a revolving stage, it was amazing. And I was pretty regularly drunk and used to fall off it quite often as it went round. But that was the Stevenage Locarno, and the band that took our place at the Basildon Locarno was the Dave Clark Five, who hadn't yet, at that time, had a hit record. They came from, I think it was the Tottenham Royal, I may be wrong. That was up in Tottenham, of course. Thanks.
Happy Christmas, everybody.
On the windowsill and angels in the snow, paper stars and ribbons all around the tree. I remember Christmas and the child in me. I remember Christmas, where a church once stood, singing carols out of tune and trying to be good, learning gospel stories at my mother's knee. I remember Christmas and the child in me. Safe and warm, tucked in bed, listening for the sound of Santa's sled. I'm still there in my dreams, but isn't that the way that it was meant to be? I remember Christmas in my little town, twinkling lights on every door, good people all around. Christmas is for children, that I do believe.
I remember Christmas and the child in me. I remember Christmas. Do you remember me?
Basil and we went on to Stevenage, so we used to do that. It was good, but we used to go fishing on the way. One of the guys in the band was a keen fisherman, and we'd go to Stevenage if the day was a nice weather. We'd leave early, go off to Stevenage and stop and have a picnic and fishing and a pint. Then we'd go on to Stevenage. Anyway, I waffled on a bit there, digressed slightly. Question, that was, and then my first proper travelling pro gig was with a guy called Steve Arlen. He was a cabaret performer, worked at the Paris Lido, the Sands Hotel in Vegas. Top, what you might call crooner, top, you know. Really good singer. Top, really handsome, good looking dude, you know, so, with his satin lapels and stripes down his black suit and bow ties, those jobs. And I had to dress like him. In fact, my first satin lapel suit was one of his old ones. He was about my height, a bit broader than me, but with the stripes down the trousers, patent leather shoes, never worn anything like that in my life before. And that was
It's very clear. Our love is here to stay. Not for a year, but ever and a day. On the radio, the telephone, the movies that we know may just be passing fancies. And in time may go. Together we're going a long, long way. In time the rockets may crumble, Gibraltar may tumble, they're only made of clay. But our love is here
now,
to
put it
stay.
Put it in the bus.
It's very clear.
Bus it over.
Our love is here to... Too complicated. Not for a year, but ever and a day. The radio, the telephone, the movies that we know may just be passing fancies, and in time may go. But oh my dear, our love is here to stay. Together we're going a long, long way. In time the Rockies may crumble, Gibraltar may tumble, they're only made of clay. But our love is here to, our love is here to, our love is here to.
Wherever Stevenage was, really beyond there, pro gig. And my first, I went back on guitar for that job. He needed a guitarist, so I had to relearn the guitar very quickly. What little I did know, when I started working as a bass player in these bands, those two bands, we were playing 3-4 chord songs maximum, you know. Suddenly, I had a 2-week period. I had to learn on the get back on the guitar. I bought myself another Strat, red Strat, rosewood fingerboard, which I'd already had actually, because I lent that to Melvin in the Planets, and he used to use that, so we all had Fenders. I digress. But the, I had to get back and start learning again the guitar, and my first thing was to go up to Chiswick, stay there for a week or two in this massive apartment of Steve's. I had about 2 weeks to learn a whole cabaret performance. Music, I'd never seen a chord sheet, quite any sheet at all. I'd all up here or in here, you know. And I actually had to learn, he got all these chord sheets, and I had a chord book with me. There weren't many guitar books in a chord book. I had to learn all standards. They're all standards, so you had all, suddenly in 2 weeks I had to learn. I think I learned more in those 2 weeks about chords I've ever learned since. I just had to, otherwise I wouldn't have got the gig. So I was learning minor sevenths, major sevenths, that was all new to me, you know. Diminished, augmented, flat fives, that sort of thing. And suddenly I was learning all these chords in 2 weeks to be able to accompany him as a solo accompanist and hand the parts round on gigs to people, to the bands, where we had to put backing groups and I had to direct the bands. So I was suddenly in the deep end there. First gig we did was the Ascot Club up in Blackpool. We did the Empress, the Embassy. We did the clubs in the West End. Steve also at the time used to do a gig, I think called Lunchbox in the Midlands. Noel Gordon used to be in Crossroads. I think she was the compere, if I remember rightly. The group called the Jerry Allen Trio, they were great. But he was doing that, Lunchbox, with a guy called Roy Edwards. They shared the gig, you know. And it was a lunchtime program, obviously, nationwide, and done from Birmingham. And we were staying in Leicester when we did the gig. We used to stay in Leicester. But
I've treated you unkind.
You two can dance, three.
The rain, just singing in the rain. Glorious feeling, I'm happy again. The clouds up above.
Leicester boy, of course, so few Leicester connections here for me.